Hey guys, perochialjoe here with Rooks Teppish. We are going to be doing a nostalgic play of Mighty Morphin Power Rangers the movie.
Featuring Ivan Ooh.
Yeah, trademark. And I am going with the man of overalls himself, Mr. Oshkosh, Billy David Yost.
I'm going with Tommy because
Jason David Frank, the actor with three fucking first names. Look at me go.
I got hit already.
For the crowd out there, I was a little too old for Power Rangers growing up. And I never played this on the Super Nintendo.
Me and my sister played this a lot. It was one of our favorite games to rent.
And the less said about her, the better.
And, I always played Tommy. He was always my favorite Power Ranger.
Tommy?
I preferred him as the Green Ranger, though. You know, the whole evil thing.
If you look on YouTube, you can find videos of Jason David Frank doing his evil Green Ranger laugh for audiences.
That's awesome.
Yeah, that's pretty whack. If any of you are curious as to what Mr. Jason David 3 first name Frank is up to now, he's actually an ultimate fighter with 5 wins underneath his belt, so keep an eye on him. He's got a pretty good ground game.
I didn't know that. So basically the way that this works, you've got, you know, 4 blocks of health, and you got a power meter. You'll see these lightning bolts that these guys are dropping. That increases your power meter, which allows you to do special abilities, such as his Billy's coin drop that explodes, and Tommy's kick. And once it completely fills up, you can
morph.
You can morph in time. Turn into your Power Ranger form, which is a lot stronger, and you gain all of your health back.
Shit, I don't need to turn into anything. I'm doing it.
And it also kills all the enemies on screen. So it's a very helpful strategy to save that when you're low on health.
I am low on health. Please morph.
Right. And then your power meter continues to fill up as you are in your Power Ranger mode. And that will basically allow you to do 2 things. When it's completely full, you can use your weapon, and your power meter just continuously drains. And it's an even more powerful version.
It's morphin' time, buddy!
That looks just like him, doesn't it?
Yeah. Alright, it's go time. Move out the way. Billy's got it.
And, when you're also at a full meter.
See? Okay. Don't give a fuck.
You can,
Billy is the honey badger of the game.
When you're also at a full meter, you can do a special ability that, clears all enemies on screen and really hurts bosses.
Or you can take a bunch of hits.
Shit.
One of my criticisms of this game is that enemies, for a walk-around brawler game, enemies have touch of death. They don't have to hit you. A putty controller could fart on you and it would cause damage.
Yeah, and
a hamburger gave me 1 unit of health. Don't they know how tasty those fucking things are? Ow!
You know Billy, he's used to the meat.
So the audience members will know David Yost, the actor who played Billy, is indeed a homosexual. Not that there's anything wrong with that.
It's just fun to make fun of.
Well, some interesting notes about...
What the hell is with my controller?
David Yost, he's actually a tremendously talented gymnast. And he wasn't allowed, or he really didn't do too much fighting on the show, to my memory. I was more into Batman the Animated Series and all that around this time. But yeah, really talented gymnast. And he stayed on Power Rangers for a great many seasons.
I remember remember there was a chance, or he had a chance in the series to be the White Ranger, I think.
Did he?
Yep.
I did not know that.
Or maybe it was a chance to be the Green Ranger or something. I just remember my sister really liked him as a character, and she was always angry about how he decided not to become the Special Ranger. But, as you can see, he's plenty special in this game.
Absolutely.
So this guy is not too hard of a boss. He just mostly warps around and jumps. He'll occasionally like shoot a beam like that.
That I just barely avoided.
Alright, so use your attack against him.
Oh, what? What? What is that?
I told you, Billy, you can't scrap with him. You see all the power he carries in them overalls?
Damn it, Billy.
Let me strike a pose now.
Special. Right into me.
Look at this. Hey! Billy's incredible. Tommy is nothing. And you got a life. What the hell?
Yeah. Tommy's nothing.
You know what? There's just no other option here. I gotta go with Billy.
I guess.
I mean, look at that hair.
I'll show.
It's like Spider-Man 3.
I'll showcase the local meathead / gay porn star.
No, that would not be Rocky. The first Red Ranger, Austin St. John, I think his name is, has been long rumored to be a chocolate thief in the adult entertainment industry, but that's actually all a lie. He just has an amazing lookalike in gay porn.
This is his attack.
This is mine.
No, I'll check
this out.
Also, you've got an up attack that will do.
hey, you good?
That your up attack will do less damage than normal, but it will knock enemies into the other pane of the screen.
By the way, it is completely not worth it to do any jump attacks in this game.
No.
Seeing as the enemies have a touch of death. I know that we talking earlier about mocking David Yost for being homosexual. He actually quit the show for supposedly those kind of reasons for being harassed by
Rocky.
Rocky. And he tried to kill himself twice. He went to a therapy group to rid himself of his deviant, hedonistic ways, I guess. But now he's finally come to terms with what he is, and that's not trying to kill himself anymore, so that's a wonderful thing. Now I got a one-up. Hot damn.
Cool. I should have got it since you killed me.
Now, a great many of you had the misfortune of seeing this damn movie. May not remember the part where you fight on a battleship. I assure you it was not in the outtakes. Now I've heard nostalgia critics say that the reason that the Black Ranger and the Yellow Ranger were replaced is because they were indeed a black man and an Asian woman. which wasn't too cool with standards and practices, I guess. But that is not the case. Supposedly, the one who played Zack was too black to be the Black Ranger. No. I like my Rangers like I like my coffee.
Not at all.
You can morph any time, but
I don't know, I'm just waiting for the opportune moment because I remember the part coming up here.
Well, give me some power, damn it.
Nope.
You know what? I don't need it. I'm fucking Billy. What is that?
Billy!
See? Take care of the mortar team. These guys launch mortar, by the way.
Do they? Is that why they're called the mortar team?
That's why I called them the mortar team.
Fuck you.
Shut up, Billy. Give me your lunch money.
Can't take Billy's lunch money, man.
He just
throws
it in.
You reach in them overalls, buddy, you'll make him come.
Then seeing how his lunch money explodes, he's thought ahead.
So that's what he did in the show, huh? Anytime Bully's going fuck with him, Billy would break out some of that C4 Syntex lunch money. Bust him up. You know what? I like Billy more and more now. Back on what I was saying about the movie, supposedly it was financial reasons that Red, Yellow, and Black did not come back, and somewhere in the 90s was a tragedy where the actress who played the Yellow Ranger, sweetheart she is, died in a car accident. So, rest in peace, Trini.
I did not know that.
Yep. I know quite a bit about this shit.
Yeah, for someone who says that you were too old to be watching it.
Oh. Ah! Spider took shit on me.
Yeah, so after the incessant ball breaking of the Vice Project Doom Let's Play, I decided to let Rooks share in the pain of
this
nostalgia game.
Truly shitty game.
Oh, what the fuck? my controller's
yeah,
arm
on the
messed
controller.
Up. So I'll just randomly start shit. Jumping.
What the fuck? You punched a putty and it flew into me and killed me, even though it was already dead.
You didn't die.
It hit me. Shut up.
I punch rotating spike balls. I'm Billy. I don't give a fuck. Honey Badger of the game.
This boss is pretty easy.
This is a blind run for me. I have no idea what to do.
I played through a little bit of this. Not too far, but...
Cannon top.
Basically, this guy just launches mortars. You run out of the way of those explosions.
Sure.
And then you jump on this panel and wail on him when he's up there. And
I notice spikes appear. Why are spikes appearing? Oh, I see where the mortars are going now, it's silhouettes.
Yeah. Damn. The little explosion leaves a little bit of an after effect there. And you see that dropping a whole lot of, the big power-ups.
Alright, goddammit.
The big power-ups give you more power. And basically, one of the strategies to beat this boss, because it takes a while just doing this, running up to him and wailing on him, about 3 hits every go, unless he does something like that, is to just save up power and hit him with your attack.
I wish you'd do more of that. That's right there.
Yeah.
Ah, time for a faceplant.
You can actually hit the mortars with your fist and blow them up before they hit the ground.
You know what? You hit a mortar with your fist. Oh, damn it. I'm still too short on juice. Oh, you asshole. All right.
He's coming to terms with who he is. Avoided suicide twice. Until he watches this Let's Play, and it starts all over again.
Oh, that's wrong.
Alright, I'll not be using Rocky again.
Use Kim.
No, I'm not playing a girl.
I'm playing a...
Her melee weapon is a bow. Not... She doesn't shoot arrows.
Your melee weapon is a little fucking dagger.
Better than smacking someone in the head with
a little Arab damn dagger.
It's a lot better than smacking someone in the head with a bow.
You know what Kimberly's power is? A vagina.
Now we get to show how rad we are.
Are you shitting me? This game is really bad.
And it's...
Can I... Oh, goody.
If you don't remember this part, it's because this part didn't exist, but the part similar to it did, where they went
skydiving.
And
Tommy was using the board, and they were wearing their corresponding colors. And
yeah.
That movie
I don't even remember why they were a snowboard.
Ooh.
These rocks will fuck you up.
Damn fucking police!
Problem. They're really hanging tin, man.
Yeah, that means.
Eh! Douche. Hey! Alright.
My foot doesn't even. My foot barely goes out past the board. And
dive!
No!
Ain't like that business.
Why can't my board be the thing that kills them? The board's gonna run into them first, my foot.
Because we're riding Zed specials.
Yeah, I guess so.
Why are we seeing so much Zed? What about Ivan Ooze? Did they go snowboarding before he was released in the movie?
It's like
the Brady Bunch reunion.
You know the
ow, damn, what the hell?
He got a duck. Pretty much in all of the Power Rangers games that featured Ivan Ooze in it, he was there as an afterthought, like the fighting game where you fought with the Megazords. Lord Zed was.
Oh, the Super NES?
Lord Zed. Lord Zed was.
Okay, this ain't possible.
Have you tried it? Lord Zed was the final boss, and, you know, he teleported.
Oh, the fighting game with the Megazords?
Yeah.
No, it was Ooze.
Shut up. I'm telling the story. And he was a pretty good boss. He was teleporting all over the place.
Is that fish?
Yes. And then they warped in Ivan Ooze right at the very end after him, and he was just ball-breakingly hard. Because he cheats.
Oh, he used the force field all the time, right?
Oh, bitch. Yeah. And used some attack to hone in on you.
My god, man. I'm about to eat it.
First time Billy has.
Billy just swallowed a load. He's done. Oh, he has credits. I'll let Tommy take a little bit of an asshole before I continue.
Hurry. You got 3 seconds.
I got 2. Oh! Look at those 8-bit artwork right there. What kind of grody shit? Yeah!
Now they give you a hamper.
My collar's flapping in the wind.
Yeah.
We're really fighting a boss on a surfboard.
My ponytail is flapping in the wind. Tommy's the guy that made my generation think that ponytails were cool.
I thought that was Terry Silver from Karate Kid Part 3.
I said my generation.
Fuck you.
Yeah, basically just... All you really have to do is watch out for this guy's fire attack.
Which I'm not doing.
Yeah. And he does that too. Generally a good strategy.
Just a fucking gang raping.
That or if you got a boss that teleports and flips around a lot, you can just.
He's riding the board of communism.
Yeah.
He's a Red Army board.
Getting the power-ups here are hard. So. Another one of the reasons why I wanted Rook to play this with me is that this game can be hard going in alone.
You can get it. Completely ignore the boss to go after a rogue power up. Yeah!
Ah!
Look at that,
asshole.
Ooh. Douche. Skellerina. We're being beaten by somebody named Skellerina.
Notice all the bosses.
Look how far I got my fist cocked back. I'm ready to go upside someone's damn head, man. Yeah.
Hey.
Billy is so the man.
Stage 3 clear.
There's 7 stages to this, right?
I don't know.
Jesus.
I've never beaten the game.
Oh, goody. Means we're going to have to go back and do some...
Means we're going to have to cheat.
Do some omaki. Us. Billy. Why don't you show off somebody else? I got the best person in the game. I can't give them up to you.
I'm not showing off the girls.
We got Adam down there.
I'm not showing off the girls. actually, I'm going to cut the video right here. It'll make editing easier.
Much.
Be right back.